It appeared after the loss in Game 5 that the other shoe was about to drop and the Rangers were going to lose in the conference finals to the Devils.
I'm in the Devils locker room, and, you know, you're just covering a team that is trying to come to grips with the notion that they're going to knock off the Rangers and they're going to the Stanley Cup final. And as the day progresses, we start to get calls from the people who are covering the Rangers saying that Messier might have just guaranteed victory.
Somehow we needed to find a way to get that confidence back, which we had lost a little bit, along with the momentum. And I didn't think much of it other than the fact that I wanted the players to know that I really believed in the team, that we could go there and win.
And I'll never forget having a hard time sleeping that night and then waking up the next morning and picking up the New York Daily News and the New York Post, and on the back of those pages is Mark Messier guaranteeing a win.
My recollection was just grabbing the paper and looking at the cover and seeing we will win tonight and just kind of laughing and shaking my head and Mark laughing too. And he said, yep, we're in it now, aren't we?
Called my cousins, said, you see this? Do you see what Messier said? He's guaranteeing we're going to win.
And I was saying to myself, oh my God, this is the kiss of death. What is he doing?
Obviously, when I woke up the next day and saw the headline smashed with, you know, I'm going to guarantee it when, I kind of wanted to roll back into the covers and say, call it a day. But it didn't really affect me once the game started.
You know, I mean, it all comes down to this game. Our season's over if we don't perform. And, you know, there's no tomorrow.
Eastern Conference Final from a packed house at the Meadowlands in East Rutherford, New Jersey. The Devils and the New York Rangers. The Devils win it. They move on to the final.
The game pretty much from the start is a Devils rampage.
Niedermeyer centering. Look out!
The team was just didn't have it. And you could just sense that here was another disappointment, another huge disappointment was about to hit the Rangers.
Rangers down 2-0, 1 minute left to go in the first period. They lose and their season is over.
And what happens is we're sitting there, the Rangers go down. 2-0, and we're like, this is it. We're gonna be done here.
Yeah,
and we didn't know what to do, so we kind of put rally jerseys on. We threw them in the corner. We moved the furniture. We did everything we can.
We were just focused on our game. I mean, we were felt we had the momentum, and we showed it because we came out in Game 6 and we're dominating the first 20 minutes of that hockey game. And, you know, we're up 2-0, and I had a little run in with Mark behind the net, and I could see in his eyes, you know, he was frustrated.
They go up 2-0. I mean, they score early in the first period, and I can say, I don't want to look at the bench and say, do not pull me. I feel great. I just want to keep playing, and I just hope that he doesn't start benching people and pulling me and changing things around.
This young Devils team with a rookie goalie named Martin Brodeur and a bunch of workmanlike forwards, not many superstars, are outplaying the Rangers. They're outworking them. After a Devil-dominated first period, the Rangers are in trouble.
The first period is over, and the New York Rangers will hear the chant of 1940 from the Devils fans as they head out.
You know, we just sat there in disbelief with our chins in our hands, saying, you know, we just couldn't believe what was happening.
2-0 lead for the Devils, second period about to start. Rangers being outshot 17-10 and trailing by a score of 2-0.
They are about to run the Rangers out onto the New Jersey Turnpike, and Mike Richter single-handedly decides that the Rangers are not going to be eliminated on this night, and he holds them in the game.
The ice is now slanted towards Mike Richter. Saved by Richter. Rebound. Saved by Richter. McLean. Saved.
He was making save after save, and we were able to weather their storm, and yet we were still down.
And Mike Richter's holding the fort right now for the New York Rangers.
If it wasn't for Mike Richter, the game could easily have been 5-1.
They had a ton of chances to make it 3-0, and Mike Richter had stood on his head. And then slowly,
the momentum started to change.
Without Mike that game, we would have never got to the third period, but he gave us an opportunity to stay in that game with another heroic, I might add, performance.
You almost felt that because they missed those chances, that it was going to come and bite them.
First time in this game where the Rangers have put on a couple of flurries in the last two shifts.
Mike Keenan had made a good move at that point and started moving lines around a little bit, trying different combinations. And, you know, he put Mark and Kovalov out there together. And Alex was our most talented player on the team. And he got an opportunity with a little space.
Mike Messier comes. Rangers need one desperately. Kovalov all alone. Kovalov shot. He scores. They got one.
And that really gave us a huge momentum boost at the end of that second period going into the third.
If the Rangers could come back and win this game, there will be a game seven.
As they went to the locker rooms for that second intermission, you could palpably feel in the building that everything had changed and that third period was going to be something special.
At least when that third period started now, there was hope, because that Kovalev goal not only created a one-goal differential, but also now was starting to create some pressure for the Devils.
Third period, game six. The New Jersey Devils lead in the series 3-2 and can wrap it up here.
We were able to string some passes together going up the ice.
Leach comes down, drops it off down on the wing.
Kovalev moving in. Kovalev to Messier. Messier shot. Score!
And he puts a shot right over Brodeur's glove.
And all of a sudden, you know, Mark scores one goal, and all of a sudden it's tied.
Now it's 2-2. Now everybody's conjuring the guarantee. Messier's just got the Rangers back to even. Now it's a Ranger building. Now the Devil fans are nervous. Now the Ranger fans in the building are electric. And you can sense that something is happening.
Four, remember, Leach moving it in.
And then there's a few shifts, and then Leach, Kovalev, and Messier are on the ice again together. And this incredible passing sequence, and there's Mark in front.
Leach drops it, Kovalev again, save on the rebound, score! Mark Messier gets his second goal! The Rangers lead 3-2! So Mark Messier is writing the stuff of which legends are made.
And now they're just several minutes away from bringing it back to the Garden for game seven. Jacques Lemaire, the first-year coach of the Devils, decides to pull his goalie.
Jacques Lemaire is going to go for it, try and get this thing tied up with a minute 53 to go in the third. Messier won the draw. Lidstra cleared it around.
John McClain tries to send the puck from in front. Messier grabs it.
That was on the ice right behind him. I could see it was basically dead center.
In the empty net, Mark Messier. Do you believe it?
When it went in the net, it clicked. I said, he just got a hat trick. He just scored a hat trick in the third period.
He called that we're going to win. He gets the game winner, and now he's just throwing in a hat trick. And I'm like, I just started laughing. I said, that is ridiculous.
He said we will win game six.
Everything changed. Everything changed about how we looked at Mark Messier. Everything changed in how we looked about the Rangers. And everything changed about all the negativity that had accompanied this team between games four and game five.
I watched him skate over to the bench with his arms raised, and I just kind of glided to the bench and was just shaking my head. I said, I can't believe what he just pulled off.
It's like it was such a you know, cool movie he just made. You know, it was just one more moment of that season that was so special.
And if you didn't believe that anything was possible after that, then you're out of your mind. We just saw something that was almost biblical. You know, predict, guarantee, and then hat trick, come on.
And for Mark Messier to come away with a hat trick, and for Mike Richter to play the way he did early in that game, was one of the great, if not the greatest, single achievement in my estimation of all time in any sport in the greatest city in the world for sports, New York.
That was one of the greatest individual demonstrations that the game of hockey has ever seen throughout its history.